It's so silent here in Oslo, the center of the capital of Oslo, of Norway. You can hear your own thoughts. But this is not how it is in only houses and apartments where families are working, maybe two people at home at the same time as school happens, and they have to take care of their children that are not anymore on the daycare centers. Hello, this is Helene Bank from Campaign from the Welfare State in Norway. It's March 26, 2020, and the country has been closed down since 12th of March 2020. It seemed as it's just been recognized by government, by parliaments, by ministries, that they have over a long, long time, the last 30 years, built down hospitals, built down the emergency centers, built down the storage of medicines, storage of food, and also relying totally on the global value chains. So suddenly they found out that something has to happen now. And now they're trying to do anything now to stop, to kill the virus, the coronavirus, and instead of putting too much overload on beds that are not there at the hospitals. The right-wing government of Norway have a very limited amount of gear in their gearbox. They think neoliberal, they think market, they think that if they prepare for the companies, things will trickle down. But luckily, the outermost right in Norway, the so-called Progress Party, had just left the government and left then the government as a minority government, which made a space for civil society, mobilization, and for the opposition in parliament to ensure that some of the reforms that came does not solely give benefits to companies, to banks, to financial sectors, but also secure workers and their social benefits. But still, there's very little limitations. We put a lot of money now into the system, but there are very little limitations on the financial sector. The banks are giving more flexibility, but they are only assumed that they eventually could give better room for companies, be more positive and flexible to what people that need to pay their interests on their housing loans. So that's the same thing with also with those who are big house owners, and no regulations in terms of rents, neither for companies nor for people. So this is a challenge that we are facing now. But now Norway luckily is still relatively strong unions that can be mobilized, relatively strong public sector that are publicly run, and we hope that we will be able to prepare for a future after the corona crisis, or living with it when it is more bearable. So I'm reading again back to Naomi Klein's The Shock Doctrine, so that we can ensure that we can mobilize for a different and more sustainable society in the future, and not just to let the market rule. So back to Oslo. Bye.